So let's discuss about the executive under the 1947 and 1972 constitutions. Under the 1947 Salisbury Constitution, they followed the Westminster format, and the 72 Constitution featured the same thing, Westminster format. However, with a small change that the 47 Constitution had the Governor General as a nominal executive, which was replaced with a president under the 1972 Constitution. So the Governor General, now first of all, in terms of power, both these guys are pretty much the same. Now even if you look at the powers of the Governor General, and if you look at the powers of the 1972 president, they are like the typical powers any nominal executive would get, right? So in terms of power, they are different. So in terms of power, they are similar, but they are reasonably different in terms of the political personality and the reputation. Now that's because under the 1947 Constitution, the Governor General was not exactly the nominal executive. Now since we were a dominion state, we were still under the British Empire. So because of that, our nominal executive was ideally the British Queen, right? So that this Governor General was the representative of the British Queen. The Governor General was carrying out the tasks of the British Queen for her, right? So because of that, the Governor General was appointed by the British Queen and also removed by the British Queen, and the locals had no say over it. The Governor General was appointed by the British Queen for the official term, and once the official term is over, the British Queen can reappoint the person or appoint someone else, and the locals had no control over it. Even removing the Governor General was a task to the Queen, and locals had no power. House of Representatives or the Parliament or the Cabinet or the Prime Minister, no one had the power to remove the Governor General. Governor General could only be removed by the Queen, right? Now if the locals wanted, they could pass an impeachment against the Governor General, right? It was possible, you could pass an impeachment, but then you had to notify the Queen that we passed an impeachment against the Governor General, so please remove this guy. So it's up to the Queen again. Even if we pass an impeachment, still the action should be completed by the Queen, right? Now comparing to this, the president under the 72 Constitution, he was locally appointed because it was the Prime Minister who appointed the president, and the president could be removed by passing an impeachment in the NSA, right? When the NSA passes the impeachment, the president is removed. No one has to make the official call, right? So because of that, we can see the Governor General and the President, they pretty much played the same role. Now if we look at the practical examples, it was the same guy who was the last Governor General, Mr. William Gopalawa. He was the last Governor General of Sri Lanka, and once they replaced Salisbury with 72, the same guy was appointed as the President. And I'm certain that he didn't really feel any difference in terms of power, because in terms of power and in terms of the role they played, it was pretty much the same Governor General and the President. However, in terms of reputation and political personality, the President had an edge over the Governor General, because the President did not represent anyone, and this person had local roots, right? Yeah. So that's about other than that, the real executive remained the same, because we followed the Westminster format. We still had a Prime Minister and a Cabinet, and that functioned pretty much the same way as the Salisbury Constitution under 72. Nothing much was changed, right? So that's about the executive under the Salisbury and 72 constitutions.